And that's where I camped last night, just down there. Little beach, secret little beach. And here's the road. And there she is, all ready to rock it.
Wild camping, the ultimate freedom to go off and to sleep in nature without paying a dime. And there are a few places on the planet that rival Norway for this opportunity. With over 200,000 islands, the third longest coastline in the world, over a third of the country covered in forest, and just 2% of the land developed on. That's bigger than Germany, by the way. It's an adventure playground for adults. But this playground, you must tread lightly on. If you're traveling by bike and you'll be mainly sticking to the road areas, then there's a lot to take into consideration and understand. Therefore, this video will explain the do's and don'ts of wild camping. We'll talk about the possible misunderstandings of certain rules, and I'll give you real examples that will help you better understand your rights and responsibilities. And remember, you have the time dividers at the bottom if required. Since 1957, Allemannsretten has been part of the Outdoor Recreational Act here in Norway. It's an ancient tradition that ensures that everybody, no matter their economic status, has the opportunity to experience nature and camp under the stars, even on largely privately owned land. However, this act only works if people follow the rules and show respect to one another and, of course, the natural world around them. Number one, you may put up your tent for a night anywhere in open country which is not cultivated or fenced off. However, you must keep at least 150 meters away from the nearest inhabited building, such as a house or a cabin. Number two, if you want to stay for more than two nights in the same place, you must ask the landowner's permission, except in very remote areas where there's no one around to be concerned about. Number three, keep your noise to a minimum. Number four, leave no trace in the vegetation or the terrain.
Leave no trace.
Of course, take all your rubbish with you. If available, use public toilets. If not, dig a hole and cover it in afterwards. Take all toilet paper with you in a plastic bag. Don't leave it in the hole or under a stone. Number seven, don't disturb animals and bird life, especially during breeding season. Same goes for livestock on pastures. And remember to close all gates after you. And I have a rule that if I'm close to human settlement, I try to be out of sight. Out of sight, out of mind. That's my rule. Those that have their livelihood in rural settings that you want to camp in, such as cabin owners and farmers, remember they have priority. You're just a guest in their area. If they tell you to move on, it's better just to move on. Don't pull out the rule book and start to argue. Of course, there's nothing wrong with you politely explaining your situation and trying to come to some compromise. Number one, land used to grow crops or plow fields. Number two, meadows. Number three, pastures, usually with livestock, but not always the case. Number four, gardens. And this can mean any sort of land that has been modified from its natural setting. Number five, areas of uncultivated land surrounded by cultivated land is not considered open country. So imagine you have three farms and then in the middle there's a small patch of uncultivated land. You can't really camp there, okay? Number six, all reservoirs, and some nature reserves. You will see signs erected in these places telling you what is prohibited. Number 7, you may find some local residents have put up their own makeshift signs preventing people from camping in their area. They've probably got sick and tired of disrespectful campers and have taken matters into their own hands. In this case, obey the sign and find somewhere else, or you risk confrontation with locals. Number 8, extremely popular tourist destinations. If you visit popular tourist spots while camping and the right to roam is usually prohibited. We'll talk more about that shortly. Campfires in or near forests are prohibited from the 15th of April to the 15th of September. Basically, in Norway, you're going to find forests all over the country. Therefore, in the summer, it's not advised to make a fire unless you're in a designated camping spot. The damage that campfires do to the vegetation is not a welcome sight. Do you want to see burnt patches all over the countryside? You can read more about the rules on campfires through the link below. Okay, let's look at 4 scenarios that I've been in to give you kind of a more or a better understanding of each of these situations. Obviously, the mountain areas are one of the best places to camp. Remote, few people about, and plenty of drinkable water. The downsides are it can be very cold, especially at night, and the weather patterns can change quickly. You must also take care with plants and vegetation as they are more fragile this high up. This place was perfect for the night. I'm about 80 meters from the main road, but hidden by the bank to the left of me. There is one cabin in the distance around 200 meters away. I checked and no one is there. It's 11 in the evening and I'll be gone at 7 in the morning. If there was people in the cabin and they saw me as I passed by, I'd probably say hello and let them know my intentions. If you want to know how I find locations like this, just click the link above.
So after doing a little bit of investigating, this is what you want to like, right? So you can take your bike over the barrier. I found a camping spot down here. So better take it easy.
Finding a suitable camping spot in the forest areas close to the road is harder than you think. There is usually very little open space that hides you from the road. The land is also very uneven, with lots of vegetation. It can take time to find the right spot, and you should always have a backup plan if required. I found this beach using Google satellite images. It's 11 at night, and I will be gone by 8 in the morning. Once again, there is a small unoccupied cabin in the distance, and behind that, there is a house which is occupied. I'm out of sight, well over 150 meters away, not causing any problems for anyone, and will be gone by the morning with no trace. A successful night's rest in a beautiful place. I try not to wild camp in the countryside close to villages. This is a unique situation where the road I'm cycling on now climbs up to 1,000 meters. I don't have the legs to do it right now and need to rest for 7 to 8 hours. I find a patch of uncultivated land not in use in between 3 farms. Now technically you could argue I shouldn't be camping here, but let's look at this situation. There's no tourists, there's no other people doing the same thing. I'm on my own with a bike. It's 11 at night. I'm out of sight. I just need to lie down and recover from a long day in the saddle. I left with no trace at 7 in the morning. Is there a problem? What do you think? If a farmer did approach me, I would explain my situation, and I just can't imagine them forcing me to leave. Here is where people don't have sympathy, and rightly so. Last year, Lufferton was overwhelmed with wild campers not following rules. This is not me, but a local posting footage of several people camping close to their property. Would you want people camping and shitting close to your house all through the summer? Wild camping in popular tourist areas is a no-go. You must camp at designated camping sites. Don't be a dick. For start off, there are polar bears. but they're in Svalbard, which is an island really far north. And there you should not consider wild camping. But on the mainland, the vast majority of animals in Norway don't pose any danger to humans, providing you stick to some simple rules. There are brown bears in the very remote areas of the far north, and there are elk all over the forest areas. Animals like these obviously command respect. Nevertheless, you'll find that if you keep your distance, especially if they have offspring, then they'll simply either run away or they won't bother you. So the biggest danger is posed by moose, elk and deer wandering out into the road without any warning. If you're driving or cycling, remain vigilant for animals emerging from the trees. So in the summer, mosquitoes and midges will be about, especially in the forest areas and around lakes. They can be extremely annoying. Bring repellent, cover your skin in the evening. If you're camping in a forest, check your tent for ticks before you sleep, and try not to walk through dense woodland where you may unintentionally pick them up. If you intentionally litter, then there is a trained team of eagle owls that will attack you and claw your eyeballs out.
I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
It's a good thing I found these mushrooms. I was fucking starving.
Know what is edible and what is not. In general, you may pick berries, mushrooms, and wild flowers, but special rules apply to cloudberries in much of northern Norway. If in doubt, leave it. Landslides and rockfalls can occur by the sea and fjords, avalanches in the mountains, and wildfires in the forest areas. Look out for warning signs and take them into consideration when choosing your tent location. Norway is one of the safest places for solo women travelers. You shouldn't feel concerned traveling and camping in Norway on your own, but always use your common sense and of course take necessary precautions where required. There are hundreds of campsites all over the country that operate from April, May to September usually. A simple search on Google Maps will bring up the ones in your area. Many are signposted. You're never too far from a campsite in Norway. The cost for one person and one tent is between 10 up to 25 euros, depending on the location and the facilities. Note, showers are not always included. If I put my tent up on the viewing platform of Niagara Falls or outside the Taj Mahal and posted it on social media, what would you think? Every year, people post pictures of their tent in some of Norway's most iconic natural settings. This is Norway's Taj Mahal. But many people from around the world don't know that. And they think, wow, what a cool place to camp. This is Norway's Pyramids of Giza. There is nothing cool or impressive about this. All you're doing is setting a bad example and encouraging others to do the same. Each day, thousands of people visit these sites in the summer. They are under constant pressure from erosion, litter, human waste, you name it. And camping is strictly prohibited for good reasons. If a growing number of ignorant people, inspired by social media posts, ignore the rules to get that photo they think is special, then authorities have no option but to restrict everyone's freedoms. We all have a responsibility to each other. If our actions explicitly impede or cause problems to other people or the land we are on, then quite simply, we are being a And there's a good chance you're going to have your eyes clawed out. By Jenny the Eagle Owl. Isn't that right, Jenny?
I will look for you. I will find you. And I will kill you.
Bottom line, Follow the rules set out to the best you can, but of course use your common sense and your own discretion in certain unique situations. By watching this video, you're taking action to understand your responsibilities when wild camping in Norway, and I thank you for that. If you respect nature, show courtesy to the local communities that you pass through, then you'll have an amazing time and be welcomed back. It's that simple, really. And I want you to remember that when you're cycling, people look at you differently, and they're going to give you a little bit more leeway, and they're going to show you a little bit extra respect. And that's going to work in your favor when wild camping. So take that into consideration. I wish you a safe and pleasant journey here in Norway, the world's most beautiful country. Harder bra.
Off we go! Off. And here's the road, ladies and gentlemen. Here's the road. Alright. In 3, 2, 1. Oh! Over! And there she is. Woo! Ready for her ride. Let's go.